love most about Kevin mm-hmm. is that he starts at zero, mm-hmm. and then in the time span of the intros that people, what's up everyone, that people don't see on YouTube but do see on Twitch, it goes from zero to about 150%.
150, dude.
And I respect that.
Everyone it in gets the energy city block out. Needs to know.
They just need to know
that we're about to go live.
I've got stuff playing in my ears. I can't hear.
It gets progressively louder. But it though. Gets. That's the thing.
That's the thing. The key. The music's here. You start like this. You're like, all right, everyone, we're going to start now.
Three.
And then you go like this.
Two. One.
Welcome to the God of Money Morning Show, everyone. My name is Nick. This is Tim. We're going to be with you for the next 45 minutes, taking you through the journey of some would say our lives. We have some fun stories to talk about. We're going to watch a couple trailers. Of course, today's episode of the God of Money Morning Show is brought to you by MeUndies, Quip, and Robinhood. We'll do those later as we give away some games. But before that, just want to take a second to tell you guys, listen, we appreciate your support. A lot of well-wishers on yesterday's episode saying, hey, we're super glad that the Kind of Funny Morning Show is back.
We back, baby.
And while I've got your attention, might as well tell you about a little deal that Amazon Prime has. It's called Twitch Prime. If you guys want to link your Amazon Prime account, you can give us one free subscription right now, and we'd like that very, very, very much. I gave mine to Snowbike Mike last month. And he did the right thing. He came at me correct, as they say in the rap trade.
Everyone loves Amazon. There's no problems with Amazon at all, especially the Kingdom Hearts Reddit. They have no problems with Amazon at all.
You guys.
They have no problems with us.
How much?
They're not taking me and Greg's face and putting it in the worst places in Photoshop.
Oh, no.
Yeah, man.
Can we bring that up? Is that something we can look at?
It's not going to be worth
look at it.
It's not worth it.
Oh, you guys.
But yeah, it's a whole thing.
Link me.
I never in my life thought that I would be betrayed by Square Enix, not once but twice. I announced the goddamn Final Fantasy 15 release date
on a
stage in front of 7,000 people. And then they delay it. I announced I'm going to have an exclusive Kingdom Hearts 3 trailer. And then the day of, I get to know, we're not getting a trailer. Yeah. We're getting a screenshot.
Cool. Well, you know what I always think, though, but I'm old school, okay? I'm almost 40 years old. So at this point in my life, what I like to say is a picture is worth 1,000 trailers. And so getting a screenshot really is the best because then you can look at it.
And when it comes to Kingdom Hearts 3, we really have got 1,000 trailers. So
here we are. This is great.
You can show them
you
this.
Just pull them up. Come on. Everyone knows it was a big kerfuffle. It's fine. We can take it on the chin on this one. Here it is. This is, who is that kid?
Sora.
That's Sora from Final Fantasy?
Nope, from Kingdom Hearts.
From Kingdom Hearts? Great.
Yeah, yeah. That's us.
They're just getting sad.
They're sad.
Are there any, is there, great stream otherwise yesterday.
Great stream. Fantastic stream.
Had
a
great time.
Whatever,
you were more stressed out yesterday than I've ever seen you in a long time.
It was a lot, man. There was a lot going on. A lot of phone calls, a lot of stuff. Yesterday was a good day overall, though. I went home. I had to organize some stuff for some work things we got going on. And I was going through old folders trying to find some notes. And I found a note of lines and ideas that weren't used in the animated show. And two that I want to bring attention to.
Give it to me.
One of them was, I don't know what the line was, but I just know what the note was, which was, that's not funny, that's just racist. So I was like, shit. But maybe, then I was thinking about it, I was like, or maybe that was the line.
That's probably
because that's funny.
That was probably the line.
That's funny. Then the other thing
I've
was,
never been known to was Kevin being like, racist.
Kevin was like, man, this lemonade's really sticky. Then Nick goes, wait, Kevin, are you drinking it out of a cup that's shaped like a bear? And Kevin goes, yes. And you go, Kevin, that's honey. That's fucking hilarious.
Because, look, when you write, sometimes you got to go to a different place.
Mm-hmm.
And that place is not confined by logic or reality.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
I get it, man.
Sometimes you just got to let your brain go.
Mm-hmm.
I miss writing things like that.
Yeah.
I don't miss the animated show. I don't miss the production.
The process of it all?
I don't miss the process of constantly eating dog shit every time an episode is supposed to come out. It doesn't. But I do miss the end result when you'd put it out finally and people go, hey,
yeah,
that's not funny at all.
You know, this is actually a perfect segue. We just talked about disappointing people with Kingdom Hearts. Now we're talking about disappointing people with the animated show. I just got an email of other people who disappoint people. I got an email from MoviePass.
Oh no.
Which, by the way, I have been done with MoviePass for months now.
Is this like the old school, like we broke up 6 months ago, but we still miss you?
This is subject, cheers, Tim. Here's two free bottles of wine to make up for our mistakes.
Maybe you still have.
What the fuck? Why is MoviePass trying to give me wine?
Trying to get your ass drunk, trying to get in that.
They're
ass.
Trying to get me back, dude? I don't know, man. Ass, this is bad.
Trying to give you a kiss.
Complimentary doorstep delivery. 100% happiness guaranteed. Dude, I feel like y'all. If you couldn't make me happy with your stupid movie service.
Stop, it wasn't stupid.
It got stupid. And now they're going to fix it with bottles of wine?
That sounds like right. Was,
your knowing was, them, it's going to be Chardonnay. Then we're all fucked.
I will say this. You two, very hardcore lovers of the MoviePass, got a lot out of that service.
Mm-hmm.
You, once you broke up with MoviePass, though,
oh, yeah.
Man, you got on that Stubbs dick.
Oh, yeah, AMC Stubbs A-list,
back.
Baby.
Man, oh, you got on that Stubbs.
I'm on it hard,
you
Kevin.
Are
I'm
on it so hard.
Me, we
and
went
it's
to
like,
see.
It's like, you know what it's like? It's like when Brad Pitt broke up with Jennifer Aniston, and everyone's like, that was a shame. And then he started, and then he married Angelina Jolie, and was like, sick fucking
it's
bird,
crazy,
doggy
it's
dog.
Crazy, yeah.
That is what happened. Dick.
Because what happened was on, I don't remember what it was, last week we went to see Creed 2, like you guys talked about yesterday. Yesterday,
so
and it was me and Gia, and then you and Yusuf came, and you guys got in line to get your popcorn. You're like, you guys get anything? And I was like, nah, we're just like hanging out, waiting for our other friends. We're not going to get any concessions. And then you're waiting in line, and then maybe 5 minutes later, I decide, you know what? I am going to get something. I'm going to get a large cup of water.
Yeah.
That's what sounds good right
now,
ice
great.
Water. So I got to skip the line using my A-list thing, and I got my water. You still were waiting.
Which was funny, because, and this really speaks to the volume of the fine workers over at the Metro at AMC, there was only like three people in line in front of me. That's, these people doing God's work.
Doing
Get
God's
me the popcorn
work.
That I want and the giant Diet Cokes that I want.
Mm-hmm.
They just couldn't give a fuck. They're like, whatever, sir, who cares?
Creed 2, what a goddamn
what a
movie.
Fucking
I can't
gem.
Stop thinking about it, man. That
gem.
Final fight.
I tell you right now, I mean, I haven't seen a lot of good movies, you know, the ones that are gonna be nominated for Academy Awards, the ones that, you know, you should see, but
you need to watch
just
Body,
not seeing.
Man.
I'll get
it's coming
I'll
out
get
on YouTube Red
Body's
tomorrow.
So good.
I'll get around to it. I'll
You're
borrow someone's YouTube Red account and maybe watch it. I'm not gonna get YouTube Red.
YouTube Premium, YouTube Original. I don't know what the fuck.
What the fuck do they call
days.
It now? You know what? I hate it because every once in a while, you know, like obviously the best part of YouTube Red is that you can just listen to shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like you can just
oh,
you can pause your thing
mean.
And it's great.
And no ads.
No ads. Well, I don't care about the ads.
You think that until you don't have them.
That's fair. But what I will say is, like, I'm getting close to it, because I keep watching. Like, I'll start watching stuff here and then go, you know what, I want to just listen to that in my car. But then I have to leave my screen playing, and it pops up, hey, we noticed you haven't touched your phone in a while. Did you want to try YouTube Premium? And I'm like, no, but kind of.
You do. You
but I don't
really
want to pay
do.
For it.
It's worth it, man.
Okay,
it's
know.
Worth it.
First up on housekeeping, ladies and gentlemen, we have two amazing new shirts. For the Christmas season, we have this awesome Glitch shirt, which Tim is also wearing.
I am wearing it.
Which I love.
Fuck.
And a lot of people in the comments yesterday were like, that shirt makes me want to throw up, but in the best possible way. Because they keep thinking it's wrong.
Oh.
Like it's glitching out.
That's the point.
And that's the point.
It's cool, man. Some old dude on the walk, one block walk from my car, complimented me.
It's a cool shirt.
Really?
It's a cool
what
shirt.
What did he say?
He was just like, hey. I really like your shirt. And I was like, you can go to kindoffunny.com/store.
Did you actually say
I
that?
Did say that.
I tell
and
people
he goes,
time.
He's like, oh, cool.
I was wearing this shirt the other day, and people were like, oh, it looks like, well, it's inspired by a LaCroix logo, right?
Yeah.
And I was like, yeah. They're like, what is it? I was like, oh, it's my company's shirt. I'm like, oh, that's a really cool shirt. And I'm like, you can buy this shirt. And they're like, I'm not gonna buy this shirt.
Yeah.
But you should buy
but
this
they could've. They
could've.
So could you. And also the side Frenchie.
This is cool. I can't wait to get these in. This is gonna be kind of nice to have something slightly different in my closet. Because I have so many of our amazing black shirts.
Yeah.
I do. This is going to be slightly different.
I really like the sleeve.
Look how hot that pink is.
Super hot.
Super hot.
Super hot. Super
I
hot.
Fucking love it.
Go over to kindoffunny.com/store right now if you guys are listening to this. Man, let me paint a picture in your brain right now. Imagine when you're cold and hungry.
God, you're so bad at this.
And you go like this. You know what I want? You know what I want, ladies and gentlemen? I want to get a large deep dish pizza. I don't want to smother my face with it. Just stick it on my body. That's what these shirts are. These are like a slice of hot pizza on a cold day.
Oh.
But you wear it on your body.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I wore the
Glitch
shirt.
I wasn't with you, but you got me
there. I wasn't with myself either.
Yeah.
Halfway through, I'm like, I'm bored.
You rarely are.
I'm bored.
Yeah.
I wore the Glitch shirt last night. Had a show last night.
Okay.
Wore it there. Got some compliments on it there as well.
Wow, you had the balls to wear a kind of funny shirt while doing comedy.
Yeah, you know, I call a spade a spade.
Yeah?
You know what
I mean? Yeah, yeah.
I'm not trying to be hilarious.
I like that.
I'm wearing just this, it's the brand, I gotta pimp it out. Which is hilarious because there's another group that does comedy that's called the Hella Funny.
Yeah, which
and I'm
is
like,
weird
this is even
in our circles.
Ah, who gives a shit? We're better than everyone.
We're better than everyone. You heard it here first.
Had a great, had a great show last night. My first time hosting the show. Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that on your Instagram. So hosting a 2-hour show.
I was gonna, my buddy was like, hey, you want to drop by for a set at this? He has a weekly show at Dilemma, which is, Delirium. Delirium. Dilemma's what I keep spelling as. Delirium's what it's called.
Dilemma's the hit Nelly Kelly Rowland song from 2004.
If I started a bar, I'd call it Dilemma for sure. Because you know some alcoholics were like, oh, fuck it, I'll have one. He was like, he hit me up last minute. He was like, hey, do you want to host this thing? And I was like, yes, because I want to host more because it's fun.
Yeah.
And it actually keeps you more engaged. And it's a better skill
set. And you get to be on stage more.
And you get to be on stage more. And
let Nick host.
I did a great
job. I've been
saying
it for years.
I did a great job. It was one of those shows where it's my favorite kind of show, where it's a comedy show where the people in the bar don't know they're about to get comedy for 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
That's always fun.
That's the worst.
That's the best.
That is the absolute worst.
Where every time I went up, I was able to get the room back, and then every comic immediately lost them.
Yeah. Because
they were like, sports.
Yeah.
Like, there's nothing
sports is an option.
More conducive to stand-up comedy than when there's 5 TVs on with different sports on.
Yeah.
That's always so super fun for people.
Super split audience. Fun for people. But wait, you did well, though.
Oh, yeah, it was fun. I had a great time, actually.
And so this is your first time hosting.
I've hosted before. I hosted that showcase we did.
This is your first time hosting a real show.
Yeah, this was my first time hosting. So it was cool. It's a nice way to, like, get to know a lot of the comics that are around.
Hey, I want you to do a lot more of this. I think this is the key to your next level
success.
The
secret to my success, yeah. I'm hoping so. So hopefully they'll give me, I was talking to him. I was like, maybe I'll do this on a more semi-regular basis. And I'm trying to get, well, I don't want to like run a room. Mm-hmm. I just want people to be like, I'm tired, you come host.
Yeah.
So then I don't have to worry about it at all.
Yeah.
And then I can on the way, like what I did was I was like,
produce it.
I was hosting. I found that an hour prior, like a couple hours prior. And I was like, perfect. And I just hit up all my friends. I was like, come by, I'll give you a set. Because then it's the best of both worlds. I don't have to worry about dealing with the fucking venue.
Yeah.
And all the bartenders and the people in these bars that think they know comedy. Like, you don't have a fucking mic stand.
Yeah.
Relax. Mm. Relax.
Mm.
You know how many times I've had to have conversations with people in bars? I'm like, turn the fucking music off.
We have to.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Yeah, you fucking shitheads.
Next up on housekeeping.
Joke time.
We are right around the corner from the Kind of Funny, the first annual.
Say that.
We'll say the inaugural.
The first ever.
The first ever. Kind of Funny Games Showcase is 1 week from this Saturday. We have 60 games to show you, and we couldn't be more excited. Come see what we've got Saturday, December 8th at 10 a.m. Pacific time here on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames. If you're watching this on YouTube, you're going to not want to miss this. Of course, if you're out and about, follow us on @kindoffunnyvids on Twitter or catch the showcase when we eventually upload it to youtube.com/kindoffunnygames. So watch it live. It's going to be really, really fun.
Yeah, watch it live. It's going to be really great. And then after it, we're doing a little Smash party.
Oh, God, I can't wait to talk
to Smash Brothers Ultimate.
How long? Wait, it goes from 10.
Wait,
it goes from 10 to roughly.
We're 10 days, baby.
Yeah. Doggy.
Two hands.
Doggy dog.
So Smash Ultimate is in my hands.
I can't wait.
Me neither.
I'm excited for that. We'll check in on some quick tips. Reminder, if you guys want to tip us at the $5 above level or give us 500 cheers, we will read those tips. You can ask us questions about anything we talk about on this show. Mario Not Bro said, glad to have you guys back. I miss y'all. Here's two short fun clips that are my dumb sense of humor in case y'all missed it. You guys matter so much to me. Love you and miss you all. He gave us those two clips. Mario, did you get your Twitter handle back?
No, he didn't.
He lost that.
Yo, this was something panda. I actually wanted to talk about.
Sad panda.
Motherfuckers, it was like a culling of people. Mario Not Bros, Roger Percorni, Millie Ramsey.
Yeah.
Everyone got.
Why would they?
Damn.
But like, how? It's interesting, because you're not allowed to have it. It was the underage thing, right?
Yeah.
They started it before they were a certain age.
Yeah.
Was it 16 or 18?
13.
So.
Which is crazy.
That's
like,
weird.
Think about how old you are right now, you know what I mean? And they were younger than 13 before they started their Twitter.
I was 18 when I did mine.
Yeah, it's weird. That's weird. That sucks.
Yeah.
It sucks especially for
Mario really does
too,
suck.
Because I used to follow him, but I'll probably never get around
to a bunch of them had a hell of followers.
Oh, Millie did?
Yeah.
Man. I'm sure Millie just got all her followers back, but that sucks. Kevin, you gonna watch these clips?
I already did.
Are we watching them?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, doggy dog. Bring them up. Here's the fun clip section. Let's go. Oh no, this is never good. No!
I enjoyed that.
That was amazing.
It was good because it was short.
Yeah, very short.
If that had gone on for another 10 minutes, it could have been even funnier.
This one, I don't know if I'm gonna like it or not. It's very like...
Let's give it what they call a shot.
It's only 6 seconds.
So it's fucked
it's
up.
Getting the pool. But is it? Because did you read it?
Yeah, I mean, that sounds really
horrible.
Yeah,
that's what...
Let's see.
Air horn prank.
Someone
say something?
Aww, making fun of old people is always fun. Here's the thing.
Not only is that mean, I think it's also fake.
Yeah, I think
that's definitely fake. Yeah. That's 100% fake. Mario.
Right, so Mario.
Christ.
One winner, one loser.
For one.
You're at a net zero right now. You got one win, one loss. You're at fucking zero, my friend. You want that follow on your Twitter? You try fucking harder. You try harder. Make those fraps. Sweet, sweet fraps. Selenera says, can I get a congrats from the champ? Had brain surgery about a week and a half ago.
What
and channeling
fuck?
Your winning spirit to still crush my two nieces and nephews in Mario Kart during Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Never let anything set you back.
Yeah.
Never let anything get in your way. Especially brain surgery. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Those fucking brain surgeons that are like, oh, I make a lot of money. Oh, I could be Doctor Strange one day. No, you can't.
You can't.
No, you can't. You can't.
I think he was just a regular surgeon.
You can't. Ant-Man 0208 says, hey, Nick. Tim, I have a question that I cannot figure out, and I think you are the man to answer it. In season one of Pokemon, in the intro, Pikachu is running and runs under a girl before diving in the air. Who is that girl that is shown?
I don't know.
Nobody knows.
Nobody fucking knows.
Damn, you serious?
It's super weird. Like, why is she in the intro? Because she does the little, like, ooh thing.
Maybe they want to, maybe they were going to write her into something else, and that episode just got canceled.
I mean, that's weird. Maybe.
It's happened before.
It has happened before. It'll happen again. Huh?
Are there any theories of who that is?
All right, do not pull this up. This will get us fucked to hell.
Well, I was just
they will claim
the most infamous YouTube fucking of all time was Smosh from Pokemon.
Really?
Yeah.
What
from the Pokemon intro. They did their reenactment of the Pokemon theme song, and it like got their channel like on the brink of destruction when they were the number one most subscribed channel in the world.
That's crazy. Yeah. Is that when PewDiePie pulled ahead and he was like, fuck you, Smosh?
No, it wasn't then. R.I.P. Smosh. They're just
Are they
gone.
Just dead?
They're just done.
I'm not showing it. I'm very curious of who this girl is.
Okay. Tim is like, don't, under do no not circumstances,
play,
play or show it. He's like, okay, play.
No, but I'm not showing it.
It made the sound, though.
It made one, like...
If we get Mr. Bucketed, you're the one that has to fight this legal battle.
That's fine. Where's this bridge thing?
And now we're just sitting in silence watching this. I'll read the last tip as Kevin searches for this woman. Bree Chi says, Dr. Keeper of the Things, what are the current five things on the list? Also, Tim, I like the hair.
Thank you.
Currently, they're the same way they've always been. One, Departed. Two, Blade Runner 2049. Three, we keep open for Jesus. Four is how much weight I need to lose after Thanksgiving. And five, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know what that joke is. One thing I wanted to do with you, Tim, because we didn't get a chance to commiserate on this yet, is a new teaser for the live-action Lion King dropped last
week. Not only did it drop, it's breaking motherfucking records.
You
see the shit?
No, but...
It's the most played... Wait, holy shit. I saw a thing saying it's the most played Disney trailer of all time.
Oh, I'm sure it is. This is just the official trailer.
And it was there's 22 million. This is now at 45 million.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. By the way, this is one of times. This is probably one of many trailers
uploaded to different
channels. I'm sure this has hundreds of millions of views at this point. But I didn't see the trailer first. I just saw everyone's reaction to it. And I was like, oh, shit. Here we go. So what I want to do, I know this is a little late, everyone. Trust me, I get it. I'm nothing if not up to speed on everything. But I do want to watch it with Tim because he's the biggest.
Have you not seen it yet?
I have seen it, yes.
Okay.
But I want to watch it again.
Yeah.
I saw it on my phone in the little fucking thing.
Gotcha.
I want to watch another big 80-inch screen that Kevin bought for us.
65.
Whatever.
And I should have gone bigger, you coward.
Mochi.
Let's go.
Already in. They had the balls to do it, Nick.
Yeah, no.
They had the balls to just be like, let's just give the people what they fucking want. Touches.
And I love that they got James Earl Jones back.
They
for
got
it.
Him, dude.
Is
they
fucking
feel like we gotta get him before he dies.
But a king's time as ruler.
Look at that shot.
Like what? Sun.
They're like, when we didn't even need to say Iron Man. Y'all know.
The sun will set on my time here. And will rise with you as the
Hit me.
King.
He looks so good, Nick. My boy Rafiki.
Yeah. But like,
the chills haven't stopped.
It's...
Oh, shit. Keep it going. Keep it rolling. Who's next? Who the fuck is next? Oh, my God. They got Billy Eichner. They got John Oliver, too, as Zazu. You ready for him as Zazu? I don't think you are, dude.
That's great.
Remember.
My friend's kid. I didn't show you this picture. I'll show you off air. My friend's kid went to the school Halloween party as Zazu.
Who the fuck is like, I want to be Zazu?
This was the most baller, like, baller move I've ever seen in my entire life. Because she was like, what do you want to be? You want to be like Han Solo or some Stormtrooper? He's like, I want to be Zazu from The Lion King.
Fuck yeah,
and
dude.
She was like, all right.
She's like, hey, we're making
it happen.
And
she did, like, I don't, for sometimes I don't understand how people can do stuff like this. But she basically was like, she put together a costume that from, like, the neck down was, like, just a regular, like, outfit.
Mm-hmm.
Took a hat, made the bill, and all the feathers on the hat. So all he had to do was put the hat on, and it looked fucking dope.
Hell yeah, dude.
And
good
I saw
him.
I caught up with him the other day, and I was like, dude. And because he was conflicted about it, because he was like, I don't know, you know, he's a kid. So he doesn't know, like, he wants to be accepted. And I was like, no. You're a baller for that.
Yeah, you're so baller, dude.
If you do this the rest of your life, people will look back on this lineage of Halloween costumes like, this kid had it.
This kid fucking
knew
it.
How old is this kid?
He's got to be like 7 or 8.
He told a 7-year-old that he had it and that he was a baller.
Never change, Nick.
Uncle Nick coming down and be like,
you got a kid. You're baller.
Because he was conflicted about it. He was worried about his costume. I was like, kid,
don't
that
be
was
worried.
Dope. No, I was like, I was like, my friend Tim would totally go as that for Halloween.
Yeah.
And he is at least 15 times your age.
So, hold on. Kevin, can you please bring back up the Lion King thing?
Wait, the trailer?
Yes. Like, there's some things I want to talk about. You can kill the sound, please.
Obviously.
Now, here's my thing.
Yeah.
Just let's get it out of the way.
Yeah.
So many people are like, it's not live action.
It's definitely
still
not
animated.
Live action.
Who gives a fuck? Nobody's claiming it's live action.
Because
but
I mean,
it makes it look like live action.
I totally get that.
It does it well.
The way I'm choosing to look at this from a positive perspective, it's like they reanimated it. They're just updating it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Like, yes, this is all fake. That's all fake. All of this is fake. This is all computer generated.
Probably. But it looks amazing.
It looks good enough to watch it and be like, this is going to be good. The question is, are we going to get into an Uncanny Valley situation with this movie? It's like the lions don't look good enough to be real, but is it going to be fun to watch this, or is it going to be weirdly off-putting the entire time?
I don't know. I mean, it looks pretty fucking good. Here, my only issues with it, because I don't care about all that stuff. It's like the reason they're like, everyone's like, why does this need to happen? The other one already exists.
It definitely does need to happen.
It's happening because they want to make money and because they want this to be seen by a whole new generation of kids.
Yeah, that's the thing.
That
like,
if they just re-release the original, they would not see it.
No, they weren't going to see it.
I do think it needs to happen because, like, I don't know that, like, the new generation of people, like, are watching it.
Yeah.
No, definitely not. I mean, that's the thing. Like, you have to understand, like, the people, kids these days, maybe they're watching the original animated show, but they're used to, like, they're used to CGI Fest. They're used to, like, Up. They're used to Pixar movies.
Gotta give them the shit, man.
This, I think, is a cool interpretation of it, and obviously, like, getting... The question is, like, it's just weird because there's so many elements that are the same, including James Earl Jones.
Good.
Where you're like,
that shows they're doing it right.
It, yeah.
He did... But it's also kind of a cheat, in my opinion, where it's like, that's going to be the question for me. Is when I go see it, I'm like, am I going to feel like I'm just watching the same movie as I've seen before? Or are they going to bring some new elements to it?
They're definitely bringing new elements to
it. It's not a bad
thing for... They're bringing Beyonce to it,
Nick. It's not a bad thing for newer generations. If you have a kid and you're like, dude, this is my kid's first time seeing Lion King, I think this is going to be phenomenal. But for me, having seen Lion King 100 times, am I going to sit in the theater and be bored? Now the answer is I don't think so, because when I watched Jungle Book, I was like, oh, they changed just enough stuff for me to feel like this is a cool interpretation of this. They added some new shit. I'm seeing some new stuff. Weird songs. Don't like that. This obviously is going to be a musical, which is great. When it came to Beauty and the Beast, I was like, I'm enjoying this, but the stuff that they added to make it a little bit newer, I hate it. I was like, this is all bullshit.
I feel like that you're just a little too tied to the original.
And also they cast Emma Watson and she can't sing for shit. But
I liked some of the new stuff they added. I didn't like all of it. Some of it was bullshit. But I feel like even with this, something's going to be better, something's going to be worse. But the only thing that I'm a little bit down on, and I want to wait to see the actual movie.
No Cheech Marin?
No.
Fucked up.
That's okay.
No Nathan Lang?
They got great people, though. Can you give me the shot of him being held up?
If you don't have Timon and Pumbaa, you ain't got shit.
It's Pumbaa, Nick. Pumbaa. You never get it right.
I know, I don't care.
I do. It bothers me so much. It's earlier. Yeah, pause it here. The only problem I'm having with this is I love the look. I feel like it looks as realistic as it needs to without having that Uncanny Valley situation going on. But my problem is the lion looks a little too realistic.
See, that looks fake. And then when you go to the lion, it looks super real.
But my problem with it is when you look at this scene
What's
in the animated
called?
Rafiki.
Rafiki
looks fantastic.
When you look
at this scene in the animated version, Simba has this more like curious, like, I'm a baby look to him that you can only get in a cartoon. Whereas this, he just looks like a thing being held up. Here. And then at the end, go to the grown Simba.
He does do a little look right there. See?
He does, but it doesn't look
he's
as...
He's terrified. It looks like he's about to get thrown off a mountain like fucking 300. Like he just didn't pass.
Go to the end.
Like, I'm going to throw your ass off a mountain.
And then my problem with Simba here is he doesn't...
Is that Simba? Simba?
Is it?
I feel like it's James Earl Jones.
Because it could be like James Earl Jones.
But I mean, it looks like he's looking up at Mufasa.
Maybe.
Yeah, but there's no clouds here. Look, it's like the day is breaking here.
I hope this is Mufasa because
I hope so too.
Because Simba had that like dope ass Pidgeotto hair. You know what I mean? Like he had like bangs going on.
Mm-hmm.
Like he looked like a teenager.
God, you know.
You know? Yeah. Whereas this doesn't look like a teenager.
Can we, without playing the music, Kevin, can we find the trailer for the original Lion King? Is that a possibility? Do we have that?
There's a side by side someone made.
Is there a side by side?
Yeah.
Let's find that. Because I'd love to A/B test this and see. Now the other issue I have is that obviously this movie is going to look awesome. But when I saw The Lion King in theaters, that thing was a masterpiece of animation, of hand-drawn animation. Phenomenal. They used some computer-generated shit for the herds and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I didn't like that. I thought that was cheap. Disney cheap.
It looks so good. Jeez. What?
Cheap. The rest of it,
phenomenal. That and The Cave of Wonders and Aladdin look fucking awesome.
How dare you, sir. Do not compare. No, I don't know. They look great.
No. Tim's right.
So here we are. We're watching side-by-side. Yeah, I just want to go back and watch the animated version again.
But you can still do that.
Yeah, that's the thing.
I can do whatever I want. I'm a grown-ass
man. The new one lacks...
I can do whatever my wife lets me.
It lacks the, like, over-the-top style that the cartoon has, but that's because it's a cartoon.
We're watching this.
Yeah,
director
no,
of the Jungle.
No, I'm just letting everyone know in the audio that we didn't drop out. You guys, we're still here with you.
We're watching the side-by-side comparison of both.
We're watching a top... bottom comparison.
Yeah, this is a very interesting thing, but whatever.
It makes sense because the planes, the aspect ratio of it is smart. He actually did this. This is how I would have done too. But
just like look at the way Simba reacts to things.
It's a lot more happy. He's happy. Like in the bottom, he looks terrified, like he's about to get thrown off. In the top, he looks like I don't know what's happening, but I'm getting a shoulder massage and I dig it.
I just feel like you
this monkey's really getting in that knot that's been
in there. Get in there, dude.
Since I came out of my mama.
I just love the painstaking detail they went into.
It's cool. It's cool.
They're like, we want to recreate this.
And the thing is, you know, it's Jon Favreau. It'll be good. It's Lion King. I mean, literally, they could just remake the fucking movie. Shot for shot, script for script, it'd be a good movie.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Let's see. I don't know.
The original Lion King, not perfect.
What do you
I'm throwing that out there. Not perfect. Every fucking Disney movie, every classic Disney movie has a problem where about 2/3 in, it speeds up too fast.
Yeah, that's because kids back then didn't have any attention span.
I get it.
The third act, like
Beauty and the Beast, tried to solve it in the remake, and it fucked it up because it was too ambitious.
Look, man.
There's the band.
Here's what I want to see. Here's what I want to see.
Pull it up. You see? Look at his hair. Like he has this kind of like.
Well, it's youthful. It's more youthful.
Yeah.
Like, bring up that versus Mufasa. Can we bring up Mufasa? How do you spell Mufasa?
Right there.
There it is. There he is, baby.
It's not that one we're used to. Youthful. I mean,
I guess we're wrong.
A little thick.
It's nice though.
It's good.
Well, either way, excited.
Scar is dope hair. Can we agree with that?
Who's playing Scar in this? Who'd they get
I
for
don't
it?
Know.
I'll find out.
Put up. Just type in Lion King cast. There's this image that has everyone's
That's
picture.
All of them. Lion King canister.
I didn't type.
To the left. To the left.
To the left. To the left. Nope. Go over to the one that has their names in the all the way over that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
As we got Donald Glover as Simba, Beyonce as Nala, James Earl Jones reprising the role as Mufasa, Chiwetel Ejiofor. God, I can never say his name. Oh, he's Scar. Oh, that's good.
I'm not familiar with him.
Yeah, you are. You've seen him in stuff before. He was in he was in 12 Years a Slave.
He was in Mordo.
Yes. He was in. Oh. He was in.
Okay.
He's awesome.
Okay.
Alfred Woodard as Sarah. Is that how you say that character's name? Robbie. It's Robbie.
Yeah.
And then John Oliver as Ozzy.
John Oliver as Ozzy.
That's a great call.
Like,
what the hell?
Such a good call.
Who's Billy Eichner?
I don't know.
Oh, he's that loud guy from Parks and Rec.
See, I don't. Here's where I feel like this movie is going to. Ultimately, this is going to be the downfall of this film.
Oh my God.
Love Seth Rogen. Don't know who Billy Eichner is. No Nathan Lane. No Whoopi Goldberg. Go fuck yourself.
I mean, dude, you can't just hold on to the past that
Go
hard.
Go fuck yourself.
Like, these guys are funny.
I know, they're going to be good. I'm just teasing. Yeah.
And they got Eric Andre as fucking Azizi. We don't need no Whoopi.
Which one was Azizi?
We good.
Was he one of the...
I think he's the, like, dopey...
The hyenas?
Hyena, yeah.
Do you know who this guy is?
I have no idea. I've seen the name.
Oh, the Billy Young Street dude.
Yeah, I'm going to play it for a second so you can hear his voice.
There are so many questions on our minds these days. Will our country always be this divided? Are our civil rights once again at stake? Will the United States continue to...
Anyways, that's who he is.
And Seth Rogen is Pumbaa? Fuck yeah, man.
That's Timon. I could see that being good Timon.
Pull this image up, Kev.
Pull it up, Kev.
This is the most... fuck you statement they could have possibly made. This is like, shut up, haters. Look what we did. And in the moment, everyone's like, oh my God, that's crazy. And they saw James Earl Jones and they're like, oh, that's right. No one can do Mufasa better.
No, you can't. Here's the thing, all kidding aside. I made a joke earlier about we got to get James Earl Jones in every movie before he dies. But let's be real. We have to get him in every fucking movie before he dies.
He's not
a young man anymore.
Mm-hmm.
We need to re-record at least 15 scripts with him as Darth Vader.
Yeah.
At least 15. Mm-hmm. Have Gary Whitta just sit in a room for fucking 20 days straight and write every line of dialogue he could possibly think. And then we need to have him narrate my life.
Mm-hmm.
And then he can pass.
How old
is James Earl Jones? Can we get a reading on that, Kev? What's the over-under? I feel like he's 89 years old. That's a very weird guess. Very specific. But that's what I'm going to guess.
He's born 1931. So you do the math.
Oh, I can't do the math on that. You expect me to do math? I ask you how water works.
What year is it?
All right, you brought up this next thing, by the way. I'm always looking at that. We'll weird this and then we'll bang out of this because Daddy needs some Chipotle.
87.
Oh, ooh, I was so close.
You were so close.
Pretty old.
All right, what is this next thing? You put this Ariana Grande teaser on there, and I said, stop. I love Ariana Grande. I don't want to know anything more about this.
Yeah.
Now tell me more about it. Let's watch it.
Is it going
to get
us in trouble?
Nah.
Hopefully not.
One time on Twitter, I heard Ariana was pregnant, so I got pregnant so we could be pregnant at the same time. Turns out it was just a rumor.
Ariana Grande told me my hair looks sexy pushback. She's not wrong.
Ariana broke off an engagement, so I found a guy to propose to me, and I broke off an engagement.
I heard she's a lesbian now and dating some chick called Aubrey. It's fucking sick.
I heard if you record her snoring and play it backwards, it sounds like Fantasia.
Ariana says, honest to God, knock me out. So I decided to punch myself in the face. It was awesome.
There you can pause it so we don't get fucking striked on this shit. I can't fucking wait for this.
What, is this a new album?
No, this is a music video for Thank You Next.
Okay.
And so she's been teasing this over the last like week with a bunch of.
We got Joey.
Get over here, Joe.
I heard the opening line or the opening like.
We notes. Got Joe's there.
What did we do to deserve this?
I don't know, but it's amazing.
It looks so great.
Everybody in the video.
Me neither.
People were very excited about everybody,
everyone,
so I feel
separately.
Like I'm just excited overall.
So pretty much over the last couple, like I think it was the last week on her Instagram, she's just been teasing out a bunch of just images of like behind the scenes stuff. And this video seems like it's going to be a recreation of Mean Girls, Bring It On, and a couple
Clueless
other.
Maybe?
Yeah, Clueless and a couple other of those movies. Mm-hmm. And they got a lot of people from those movies to be involved.
Cool in here too.
To be involved in it. So, like, I just can't fucking wait
Aaron
for this.
Aaron Samuels in the trailer for Mean Girls?
The dude from Mean Girls.
Wait, who's Aaron Samuels?
The
he's
boy.
The love interest.
I gotta go back and watch Mean Girls.
So that's great. And the opening girl, the pregnant girl, was Miranda Sings.
Yeah.
From YouTube.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah. And she's actually pregnant now.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, well, that worked out for her.
Yeah.
Didn't
yeah.
it?
It did work out for her.
She looks so different.
I like when people are method like that. Yeah. You know, we're like, I gotta play well, but I'm pregnant. That's the guy. Is that the guy from Mean Girls?
Yeah.
Okay. He's old as fuck now.
And that's what happens with age.
Who are these two people?
She was in the original one.
In Mean Girls, yeah. On the right.
And then who's the guy? Who's that?
I don't
Army
know.
Army pants and flip-flops. She's that girl. I don't know who this guy is either.
He's pretty,
I don't know
though.
Who those two are.
Look how pretty he is.
There's a lot of people in the chat saying
his
I've never seen
Mean Girls.
Blue eyes
are super
Girls.
Crazy.
Wait, you've never seen Mean Girls people in the chat?
Mean Girls is great.
After Kind of Funny Games Daily today, before the Patreon episode of Game Over Greggy Show, watch Mean Girls. Mean Girls is one of my favorite movies of all time, full stop.
It's so good.
It's a good movie.
It's a good fucking movie.
It's also probably, and dare I say, the last good thing that Lindsay Lohan did before she spiraled out of control. And Lindsay, if you're watching, I'm ready.
I'll
save you.
I don't have I'll a rebuttal
you.
For that.
Yeah.
Now, has anyone seen Mean Girls 2?
Oh,
no. No,
mean
God,
Girls
no.
Mean Girls 1 is not streaming anywhere for free.
It used to be.
It's worth $2.99 on Amazon, man. I'm telling you.
It really is.
It's so damn good.
Yeah, because if I'm not mistaken, wait, I thought the girl in the beginning of it's that girl.
No.
No?
No.
Isn't that
no.
the girl from it? No.
That's Lacey Chabert. She's in a metric
she's in
fuck
Not Another
ton
Teen
of
movie. She's
Christmas
the, she's the girl that gives
right
a hand
now.
Job at the end of Not Another Teen movie.
Oh yeah. Really? That's a funny movie. Yeah, this movie's great. Tina Fey, mm-hmm. I believe, wrote and produced this. I don't think she directed it.
I believe so.
Also has a good, not Tracy Morgan, what's the other guy? Doesn't matter.
Oh, yeah. The principal.
Fuck, he's so funny in this. All right, that's it. That's all we got, ladies and gentlemen. Full stop.
I can't wait.
Nothing left, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go into some tips real quick. But before we do that, let me take a second. Let's slow it down a little bit because I want to talk about Tim and a specific part of Tim's body, specifically his underwear, ladies and gentlemen. This year, this is the year that you can finally tackle your holiday shopping early. And guess what? You can get everything you need for you and your loved one at MeUndies. That's right.
True.
MeUndies, bringing you the Kind of Funny Morning Show. Yet again, MeUndies uses that coveted micromodal fabric, which is 3 times softer than cotton. You've never felt this fabric. Get ready. If you've never felt this fabric, get ready to experience pure bliss in underwear form. Tim?
It's true.
Are you wearing the underwear right now?
Of course I'm wearing the underwear right now. On top of that, Nick, I went a little overboard this Black Friday.
Oh my God, what'd you do? You go hard?
I was like, look,
you get into the
I really
prints?
Love these shirts, the MeUndies shirts. I was like, why am I playing this fool's game of having to wash these things every like couple days? I'm just going to buy a whole bunch of them.
You should.
So guess what?
Yeah.
I did.
Yeah.
I got a whole bunch of blacks. I got a whole bunch of whites. I got a whole bunch of grays.
Beautiful.
I'm just, the basics, I'm good.
So you,
do I get them V-necks? I got them V-necks.
You did. It's like you started with the midsection and now it's growing up and down.
Yeah, and down because I got the socks too.
You got the socks as well. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to get in the holiday spirit, MeUndies has you covered. Speaking of prints, this holiday season, MeUndies will be releasing a new print every Tuesday. That means you'll have no excuses not to celebrate the holidays right down to your very core. But why stop at Undies, like Tim is talking about? They got lots of stuff. This year, MeUndies is launching their holiday prints in lounge pants and onesies as well. Both are made from the same micromodal fabric as their underwears. Seriously, how can you not get you and your loved one a matching holiday-themed onesie this year? Here is the offer. Listen up. MeUndies has a great offer for the listeners. For any first-time purchasers, when you purchase any MeUndies, you get 15% off and free shipping. This is a no-brainer. 15% off of a pair of the most comfortable undies you will ever put on. To get that 15% off your first pair, free shipping, and 100% satisfaction guarantee, go to MeUndies.com/morning. That's MeUndies.com/morning. Next up, we have Quip. Let me tell you about Quip. I got one. I like these things.
Mm-hmm.
They look good.
Yeah.
They feel good.
Yeah.
They help me.
Clean
my
brush
mouth.
Your teeth.
Yeah, absolutely. When you think of the perfect gift, you probably don't think of an electric toothbrush. But the Quip electric toothbrush is one of the most gift-guided gifts of the season. And here's why.
Oh.
It's perfect for everyone with a mouth. And it's something they'll use twice a day. It's true.
That's
that
true.
Had me. That took a second for that. I was like, wait.
Gift-guided. Meaning it's in the most gift guides for the holidays. And honestly, an electric toothbrush would be an amazing gift.
It's actually
people
really a good gift.
Don't think about it.
And the
you
thing,
know what I mean?
Yeah.
But if they got it, you'd be like, huh, I'm gonna use this.
I've used this and I like it because I've discovered multiple times, every time I use it, I'm like, I am not brushing my teeth long enough. It's got a built-in time.
How long do you need to brush your teeth?
2 minutes. This has a 2 minute timer on it and it pulses every 30 seconds to let you know to change to different portions of your mouth. It's Fantastic. Quip is the gift that keeps refreshing with brush heads automatically delivered on a dentist recommended schedule every 3 months for just $5. And you can even gift prepaid refills for a year to make sure they've never that the people you're gifting to are never using old, worn out, or ineffective bristles. Quip is one of the first electric toothbrushes accepted by the American Dental Association and has thousands of verified 5-star reviews. Here's the deal right now. Quip looks like a big ticket tech gift with a stocking stuffer price, but it's just starting at $25. And if you go to getquip.com/KFMS right now, you get your first refill pack for free with a Quip electric toothbrush. But you don't have to tell that you're gifty that. That's your first refill pack free at getquip.com/KFMS. Lastly, we have Robinhood. Kevin, you like to invest your money.
I sure do, so should you.
You should. You've used the Robinhood app here, haven't you?
Yep.
You like it.
Very easy to set up.
And
you
with Kevin,
free stock when you do it.
You've seen how many things Kevin has to set up. And let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, he never says things are easy. He says a lot of times, Nick, things aren't working. The fire is rising.
The fire is rising.
This, he said he really, really liked. And Kevin is an
investor.
Easy
to set up.
We trust him right there. Let me tell you about Robinhood. Robinhood is an investing app that lets you buy and sell stocks, ETFs, options, and cryptos, all commission-free. They strive to make financial services work for everyone, not just the wealthy. This is a non-intimidating way for stock market newcomers to invest for the first time with true confidence. Other brokerages charge up to $10 for every trade, but Robinhood doesn't charge commission fees. Trade stocks and keep all of your profits. Learn how to invest as you build your portfolio. Discover new stocks and track favorite companies with personalized news feeds, custom notifications for price movements, so you never miss the right moment to invest. Here's the deal. Listen up. Right now, Robinhood is giving listeners a free stock like Apple, Ford, or Sprint just to help build your portfolio. Sign up at morningshow.robinhood.com. That's morningshow.robinhood.com. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, we give away a game here each and every day. There are 4 ways to win. 1, be in the Twitch chat. 2, be a Twitch subscriber. Hey, you got Amazon Prime? Amazon Prime's calling. Do you want to answer the phone?
Hey, Amazon. What's up?
They give you 1 free Twitch Prime.
Oh, do you have a screenshot for Kingdom Hearts? Yeah, that's it. That's all you got?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Okay. Well, this is going to be a hard day. Real hard day. Some say the ramifications of this will echo through eternity, just like in that movie Gladiator. Thanks, Square.
It's a good movie.
It's a great movie. Also, you can back us at the $2 above level on either of our Patreons. That gets you entered to win today. The lucky winner comes from the Kind of Funny Games Patreon. Congratulations, Josh Jackson, who I really
Josh
hope...
Josh Jackson, really Jimheimer Smith.
I really hope it's Joshua Jackson from Dawson's Creek and Fringe.
I don't want to win.
And The Affair. He's so good in that.
I have breaking news that I know Nick Scarpino will be very excited
about. He is one Hello Neighbor on Xbox One. Yes.
Guess what has been confirmed? A sequel to All the Boys I've Loved Before.
Really?
Well, there's like 4 more books in the series.
I know, but the director She's loving confirmed more boys? That they're working on it, and it got picked up. There's like some deal with Netflix and Paramount.
Is it going to be to all the girls I experimented with in college?
Oh, God, I hope so. No, what I really want is I want it to build it to all the threesomes I can see on Pornhub. Oh, that'd be fantastic.
We just got
to
keep going.
We just keep going with it.
What a great naming convention.
I love it, this. I love Lana Condor. Excited. I love that cast. But is she going to be dating the same guy, or is it going to be at college?
So the last boy that she sent a letter to popped up in the post-credit scene. Mm-hmm. It's like the one from whatever like camp she went to. And so it's a love triangle between the three of them.
Love triangles.
Hot.
It's so fun. Yeah. I'm very excited.
Hey, I'm going to say I'm here for it.
Yay!
I'm down. Why not?
This is...
It wasn't the worst hour and a half of my life.
I'm sorry. I'm going to have to ask you to speak to the hand while Joey and I have a conference here. Do you remember when you and I were all about this and Tim Gettys, hating ass Tim Gettys, was like, it's not that good.
It's not that good. It's not that bad either.
Nah, it's a middle of the road rom-com. It's a young adult rom-com.
But I think it's way better than the normal Netflix original rom-com.
It's very fun and well put together.
That's a fair statement.
Yeah.
Because Netflix original movies, for the most part, are garbage trash heaps.
But they found the rom-coms is their like sweet spot because they were really good at the setup too.
I tried watching that Adam Devine movie. I think it was Adam Devine.
Oh yeah, the time machine one.
Yeah, where he got, and I'm like, no,
it
I can't get 5 minutes into
it
this
was
fucking
bad.
Thing. It's bad.
And it had him and what's her name?
A great cast.
Alexandria
Daddario.
Daddario.
Yeah.
God bless her.
God bless her.
God bless her.
I didn't hate that one. It was good to like have on the background while I did it.
Yeah, I couldn't. I was a Nick. It was on for like 10 minutes. I'm like, this is a waste of my time.
This is a garbage truck.
I don't think he's a great leading man.
No,
I think he's the fun side person.
He's a good sidekick. Like in Pitch Perfect, he's perfect.
Yeah, I watched Pitch Perfect one over the weekend. I was like, oh, I should watch the third one. Didn't do that.
Pitch Perfect is so, it's such a fascinating trilogy. Mm-hmm. If you just forget about two, it's so good.
Just go, don't watch one to two. Three.
Just remember that in two, we are introduced to Hailee Steinfeld's character, and she's phenomenal. And then just skip to three.
Mm-hmm.
God bless him. Going back to tips real quick before we round out the show, DJ Kento gave us $5 and said, first, the reason there's that skirt shot in Pokemon intro is the Japanese theme has a line about them hiding in a girl's panties. No way. Not a joke. Secondly, okay, Lion King will be the highest grossing film of all time.
What?
Bet, question mark, bet. Panzer G2 says, Tim plans to play Smash with the community, question mark? Asking. Are we playing with them?
We don't have probably plans, not. But like, I'd love to at some point. We gotta figure that
eventually,
out.
Eventually, but yeah. Not, probably not on that Smash.
No, game. Not during the
We're
the
too selfish Smash for that. Thing. I'm just gonna play with you.
Hold on. Lion King will be the highest grossing film of all time. Honestly?
I don't think it will.
It has a chance. Think about it. Do the math on this.
Are they gonna release it in 3D?
I remember reading somewhere.
People aren't gonna be as excited to go see it in 3D as they were for Avatar. Avatar broke the game.
Oh, you're right. Avatar 3D. Did fuck things up.
Yeah. Hmm. And I hate that people didn't, like, that people are so against 3D. I love it.
Yeah, it's still Avatar.
Because I remember, like, Lion King, I remember reading in college, there was, like, crazy-ass stats about it of, like, because of how the merchandise worked and home video and all that stuff, it ended up being, like, the highest grossing thing of all time if you include home video.
Yeah.
So, wait, which one? Like, Lion King.
Oh, the original. Interesting.
Like, which you wouldn't really think about. Lion King is fucking huge.
Oh no, Lion King was a movement.
Yeah.
It was amazing, but we'll see.
Hey, interesting.
Someone's got to dethrone James Cameron for the number one and number two spot of highest grossing movies of all time.
Maybe is he not. Number two?
He's got Titanic. Yeah.
Wait, is Titanic still number two?
That's what it says according to this random Google search that I just did. Star Wars: The Force Awakens apparently is coming in at number three, right above Avengers: Infinity War. And Jurassic World? Fuck you.
Jurassic
Fast 7.
World? Yeah, Fast 7!
Cool. Going back to tips. Let's see, DJ Kendo gave us another tip and said they re-released Lion King in 3D and IMAX a few years back. I came to the Metro to see it, and the theater was almost empty. In IMAX, that never happens. Kids don't care to see it again. It was me, my ex-girlfriend, and a bunch of other adult nerds. I don't think it's that kids don't care to see it again in theaters. I think it's just because they've seen it on VHS.
It's just, those movie re-releases are for such a niche audience.
Yeah,
like, that is not, there's no hype for it. There's like, the trailers aren't real trailers. They're kind of just like those weird Fathom event spots you see before movies.
Yeah.
Like,
we're releasing the Lion King.
That's not a real push.
Also, like, if you have a child that's under the age of probably 10, getting them to, I don't think the theater experience is what they're craving. They probably want to sit in their living room with their toys and watch the movie, and that's what they want to do. You know?
I don't know. I mean, they're going to come out in droves to watch this one.
No, for the new one, yes.
Yeah.
I'm saying if you gave me the choice of, Nick, you want to go to the theater to see Lion King or fucking watch it on Netflix? I'd be like, yeah, I'm going to watch it on Netflix
because
I don't want to leave. And if you're a parent, you're not going to take, you're going to get all your kids in the theater. No. You spend $50 to watch a movie you can watch for free on your TV? That's not how parenting works, son. I don't know what your mom was all about. My mom was like this. Is it free? That's what we're doing.
That is what we're doing.
What do you got here, Kev?
Oh, I'm just looking at the list of, like, all-time adjusted for inflation, which I don't like because, also, Gone with the Wind was released so many times in theaters over so many years.
Still count?
It stayed in theaters for, like, 3 years.
Still count? Well, that's because they only had four movies.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like,
so, like, you got to just keep putting it in theaters.
I just don't feel like that.
Yeah, I don't fuck with this inflation stuff.
No.
Money's money.
Avatar's number one. Give it to James Cameron. He's a badass.
Yeah, Avatar, Titanic, Star Wars, Avengers. Crazy.
God, Black Panther's on that list.
Guys, 10. Like, did you see the thing going around about...
Fallen Kingdom?
About Disney next year?
Well,
Kevin, go to Twitter. Go to Twitter, and then in the search thing, because I don't know what his actual name is, type in Shinobi.
That's the... when I lived with my buddy...
S-H-I-N.
I used to live with my friend Scott, and we would scream Shinobi at each other before we flung pillows at each other. The like top one.
It's hilarious.
I know.
Scroll down a bit.
That's a dope logo.
Keep going down. There's like a Disney thing that you'll see.
Is it that one?
No, it has like, it's like a bunch of movie posters.
While you're looking for that, DJ Kendo, Kala gave us tips and hope everyone had a great Thanksgiving. I played Smash with my boyfriend and his brother and was getting destroyed until I thought, what would Nick do? So I chose Dark Pit and won my only game that night. Thanks, champ. You're welcome.
There you go. There you go.
Oh, it's a fucking great gift.
Look at this.
GIF.
Next year, Captain Marvel, Dumbo, Avengers 4, Aladdin, Toy Story 4, Spider-Man Far From Home, The Lion King, Artemis Fowl, which I don't know what that is, Frozen 2, Star Wars 9. Disney is
they're killing
about to destroy next year.
Artemis Fowl is like a sci-fi fantasy book series. Yeah. There's actually a teaser out for it today, and I watched it, and I was like, this does not look good.
No, the whole, like, anytime anything's underground, I'm just not interested.
I don't like it. Yeah, it's weird. It looks like kind of like Harry Potter, but with underground people. It's, I don't know, they're all trying to get Harry Potter. They're all just trying to be Harry Potter.
Yeah, they're all
trying to be Kenneth Branagh's directing it.
Gotcha.
We'll see what it does.
What has Kenneth Branagh done before?
Kenneth Branagh?
Yeah.
He did Thor.
Well, he's also
a famous actor. He was just in the first two Thors? No, he did the first Thor.
He directed the first Thor? Mm-hmm.
And he also was in Murder on the Orient Express, the newer one. Kenneth Branagh's did a ton of stuff. Most famously, great rendition of Hamlet. It was like 4 hours long. And by great, I mean I watched it for 2 days, or actually like 3 days straight in my lit class in high school, and I was like, this is awesome.
This is great. Just watch the movie. They like wheeled the TV in.
Press play. That's so stupid. DJ Kendall gave us another tidbit that I would absolutely pay more on Patreon if you guys did movie commentaries, and the first one better be Mean Girls. Also, Mean Girls and Clueless are in a $10 bundle on iTunes for those who haven't seen them yet. That's a great deal.
Man, those are two great movies.
Great movies. Final tip for today comes from Jeff the Maverick. Says the Aquaman social reviews are in, and they're overwhelmingly positive. Also, watch The Christmas Chronicles on Netflix. It's a Christmas movie where Kurt Russell is Santa, and it's everything. Fun fact, Andrew Renee walked in way early today and talked to me about that, and I put it on my Netflix queue.
Okay.
Yeah. Also, just a quick reminder, every DC movie has very positive reviews on social before it comes out.
And here's the problem.
Because they make the reviewers not say anything negative about them.
It's the overwhelmingly
positive. This movie has
positive.
Lots of interesting things
I would not say they're overwhelmingly positive.
Yeah.
Majority of them are positive. But even then, none of them are overwhelmingly positive. They're all like, hey, it's okay. It's pretty good. Some of them are like, hey, it's good, and it's kind of like there's always weird qualifiers to it. Like, I saw one person be like, the last half of the movie is absolutely bonkers and hella fun. Mm-hmm. And the whole thing is kind of like if Hideo Kojima did Avatar. And it's like, they kept putting in so many different things that I'm like, this sounds fun.
I would not want to watch a Hideo Kojima directed Avatar movie. The 8 hours long and never end. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're a bit long right now, so I apologize we can't talk to the chat. But remember, if you guys are watching this on YouTube right now, let us know what you thought about that Lion King trailer. And if you don't have anything better to say, the word of the day is...
Oh, shit, I didn't prepare this.
There it is. Oh, shit, I didn't prepare this. That's going to be the word of the day today. I like to spring it on.
Yeah, I like that. That was good.
Tim, you're awesome. Love you.
You're awesome, too.
Everyone, remember, please like, subscribe, share, all that jazz. It's been my pleasure to make the show for you. Kev, great job today. We'll be back tomorrow, 11 a.m. PT, here on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames. But until then, I love you. Think of me.